Hey guys, so today I just wanted to come on here and kind of do a different type of video. I haven't done this before on my channel. I want to do a little bit of a declutter video and just kind of like show you what I'm getting rid of, kind of organize my drawers, and I just want to do like a laid back kind of video, you know? If you guys follow me on Instagram or if you saw my post on the community tab here on YouTube, you would know I'm feeling a little bit kind of uninspired and just like kind of bleh right now, honestly. I don't really know why, but I'm just kind of at this point where putting makeup on my face sounds like a chore to me, and that's not something I want to do right now. I've been focusing a lot of my energy on myself and just my mental health, my nutrition. I've been working out every day and just trying to like just be better overall. So I'm trying to get my inspiration back, my motivation back, and so I've been kind of cleaning up my beauty room and changing things up a little bit. I went to Home Goods the other day just to buy whatever kind of speaks to me. Home Goods is the best store ever. And I bought like some new knobs for my dresser, a little painting up there, I'll show you later. I got a plant in my room now, a real plant, so I'm just kind of switching things up. I ordered a new desk from IKEA, so I've had this kind of crappy table from Target. It's just like, it's a fold-up table, and so I just want to up my beauty room so I just feel happier when I'm in here. I also think I'm gonna switch to Alex drawers finally and get rid of these plastic organizers as well. We'll talk about that a little later. Also, what do you think of this black sweatshirt with my logo in white on it? It's kind of different, but I kind of love it. Of course, I still love my white hoodie because like it looks like an actual eyeball, but on here, it's kind of different. You see what I mean? I've literally been wearing this one all the time. It's not for sale yet, just because I wanted to kind of get people's idea on this kind of inverse coloring logo design. I think I'll have a black shirt with a white logo up for sale sometime this month, and I also made phone cases as well, so I'll let you guys know when those go live, but I think this is super cute. I love that. All right, I got my iced coffee. Let's get into some organizing. Okay, so like I said, I'm getting Alex drawers, so I just want to clean everything out and just get rid of some things, maybe donate some things. I don't know. I'm going to start with some eyeshadow palettes in here. I love this palette. I need to use that more. This one's pretty... Oh, I never use this. I don't like colored highlighters. I'm probably gonna get rid of this one. Urban Decay Elements. This one's just freaking huge. And I'm probably not gonna use it again. If you guys watch my beauty room tour, you would know I'm very realistic about the makeup that I keep. If I'm not gonna use it, I'm not gonna keep it. Naked Heat. Love this. Venus XL. This one's really pretty as well. Keep that one. Lunar Beauty. I love this palette. Oh, I gotta keep it. Peaches. This is a good one. It smells so good. I only own like two Too Faced palettes, so I will keep this one. What is this? Oh, this Coastal Scents one. I'm not gonna keep this. It's really similar to the Urban Decay Naked Cherry palette, and I'd rather have the Urban Decay one than this one. Born to Run is an interesting palette, but I will keep it. Oh, this Smashbox one. Yeah, I'm not gonna reach for this, so I'm gonna get rid of that one. Naked Cherry, keeping it. Too Faced Pretty Rich. I don't know. I think I'll hang on to it for a little bit longer. Violet Voss and Nicole Concilio. This is an older palette. I really try to keep makeup that's recent, and I know you can't even really get this anymore, so I'm probably gonna get rid of this one. I do like the colors, but I definitely own similar things. Lime Crime Venus. I love this palette. Ooh, these shades. Keeping. The Sahara palette by Juvia's. This is the only Juvia's Place palette I own, so I will keep it for sure. I need to get more because I do want to do more videos with this brand. These are some Makeup Geek shadows. I will keep these. I like to hang on to singles, like, just in case. Okay, so that's pretty good. I got rid of, like, 5 palettes out of that drawer. Do it by brand if I can. Ugh, why? Okay, done. Okay, next drawer. Okay, this drawer has a lot of smaller palettes in it. Okay, Huda Beauty Coral. I actually haven't even used this yet, but I want to, and I do really like these palettes. Like, look how cute that is. I do really like these. Dream Street, love this palette. Violet Voss Holy Grail. I think I have a few of these in here. Okay. Yeah, so all these fun size palettes, I probably don't need 5 of these. Let's see what my favorites are. Le Macaron. Yeah, I don't like that. Creme Brulee. I don't love it. Fruit Sorbet. This one's pretty fun. I'll keep that. Berry Burst. I did a video, I think I compared it to Modern Renaissance, kinda. So these two are similar, Berry Burst and Mini HG. I mean, I obviously don't need both. I still can't get over how similar these look. It's ridiculous. I think I'm gonna keep Berry Burst. This Makeup Geek one, Peach Bellini, super pretty. I also have the Champagne Rosé. I just love her shadows, so I will always keep them, honestly. Dose of Colors, I think I have a few of these. Yeah, I do. I love, these palettes are really nice too. Sassy Siennas, love, Pretty Cool, love, and Baked Browns. Like, these are incredible shadows. I have 2 Melt Stacks in here. These are amazing shadows as well, so I will keep them. This little Natasha Denona holiday palette from, like, I think it was 2 years ago. I love these 2 colors right here, so I think I will hang on to it even longer. Then we have these little mini Urban Decay palettes. Oh, this one just like brings me back to old school Urban Decay, so I will keep that. That's Bailout. It's kind of more berry toned. I probably won't keep that. Ooh, this one I really, really like too, actually. Like, this color's fun. Like, oh, I like all these colors. I'm keeping that. Fenty Beauty Moroccan Spice palette. I have to keep it. It's Fenty. Ooh, Dose of Colors Desi and Katie. It's so nasty in here. I don't use it, but I'm gonna keep it. This Tarte Maneater palette has like all the neutrals you would need in one palette. It really reminds me of like a wedding or a bridal kind of palette, but I never reach for this, ever. I don't need it. I don't need it. What is this? Urban Decay Electric palette. Okay, this was my shit back in the day. I will never get rid of this. This was a Makeup Geek palette. I don't know the name of it, but it's super pretty. Look at that. Love it. This Deca Scarlet palette was made in collaboration with one of my friends, Christina, who lives here in Oregon, so I will keep that just to support her. Like, how cute. This yellow is awesome. Natasha Denona Safari palette. I have a love-hate relationship. Ooh, wouldn't it be cute if I paired it with the Biva palette? Oh my goodness, how cute would these be together? This is why we go through our makeup, so you get inspiration. Okay. Would that be a good video idea? Let me know, because I kind of love those two together, even though this one's a pain in the ass to work with. It's fine. I'm gonna set those two together. I've had these forever. These little mini Smashbox photo shot, cover shot palettes. Oh, see, how fun are these? That's why I kept them, because they're cute. Does this look like the Berry Burst, kind of? Okay, that's the Violet Voss Berry Burst, the Smashbox one. Formula-wise, I prefer Violet Voss, so I'm gonna get rid of this Smashbox one. So like I said, those mini Huda palettes, these are freaking awesome if you need pops of colors, so I will hang on to all of these. Then I have this little mini Makeup Geek quad. I really, really like this. And like I said, I have the other Obsessions palettes. This smoky one is amazing. Gemstone, super fun. Yes, love it all. Then I have Anastasia Norvina and Modern Renaissance. Let me show you something. If we pan over to the side here, let me just take away my Windex and my new organizers. I actually keep my other Anastasia palettes in this cute little glittery box because it's cute. I don't think I could ever get rid of her palette, so I just kind of keep them in here. I think I'm gonna stick Norvina in there as well because I have a hard time using this palette, but again, I can't get rid of her palette, so that one's going in there in my glittery box. Back to where we were. Windex. Jaclyn Hill Vault Collection. I have to keep it. A lot of people have been asking more videos with this collection. Let me know. Maybe like using some of the palettes together. I don't know. Come on. Now we got lashes, and this drawer is ridiculous. Ugh, I hate this drawer.
This is my label maker that I love.
I don't even know how to organize this.
I'm just gonna pull everything out.
Okay, we're back to the floor. My leg is falling asleep.
Here we go. Huda Beauty lashes. I really don't like her lashes. I have tried them so many times, but I just find them to be so stiff and so just fake looking. I think they're not cute. So I'm actually gonna get rid of all these, and I have used them. So that means they're garbage, unfortunately. House of Lashes, I love like pretty much every style from them. Natalia Lights are amazing. Look at those. I have a lot of House of Lashes. They always send really nice packages. I'm just gonna stick those there. I like these. I met this brand at iMats and they were super duper sweet. Okay, those are gorgeous. I really like these and I want to use them, so I'm gonna put them on my desk so I remember to grab them later. These ones are pretty too. They're nice and fluffy. Icon Lashes. Ugh, I like how they look, but they're really, really, really long. But I love this style. Oh, I'm gonna keep them. These Violet Voss ones I did use once. I'll keep it. I have way too many House of Lashes, though. House. More Huda. Like, ew. Garbage. Lily Lashes are freaking beautiful. So, keeping those. Socialize. These ones are pretty old. I do really like their Silver Series a lot. Are these Electra? I think I have another pair of these, so I'm gonna get rid of these because they're actually pretty gross and old looking. What does this say? Lava? Laura? I think it says Lava Lashes. I got these at iMats as well. They're really pretty. I'll keep them. More Lily Lashes. These are huge. A random Milk makeup stamp. This is the Gemini because I'm a Gemini. I won't get rid of this, but I don't know if I'll ever use it, so it's just gonna stay with my lashes. More Socialize. These are so pretty. These are Fleek. Keeping those. Don't even know the brand of these. More Lily Lashes. They're cute. House of Lashes. More Socialize. Ravishing are some of my favorites. Socialize, Minx 2.0, and Ravishing are like my two all-time favorites from them. Love. And we got Huda Beauty, Farrah. Like, they just look so fake. But these are not used, so I can actually give those away. I like to reuse PR boxes for organization. You know? So these are all the same, so I can put two of those away. There! So much better. Now I can just nicely stick that in there. And then I'll just kind of keep my Lily Lashes there. Throw my thing back in there. And of course my Milk makeup stamp. Good. Dunzo. Okay, next drawer is foundations. I have two foundation drawers. This one is for my lighter shades. This one's for my fake tan shades. And no one needs as much foundation. I'm never, ever, ever going to use all of these, so I'm sure I can get rid of a lot. Too Faced Born This Way, obsessed. Love. Elsie, full coverage, love. Fenty, like you can't throw away Fenty. I have to keep this. Too Faced powders, I use these all the time. I do like this one. I like the Benefit Hello Happy. They're very nice, like a soft matte kind of foundation. This Milk makeup one, I can't seem to like. Everyone says they freaking love it, and it does not work for me, so I have to get rid of it. I have the Smashbox concealers that were in that PR package. Why do I have so many? I don't know what my shade is. Definitely not this one. I'll have to hang on to these. I don't know. Vitalist Healthy Elixir, obsessed. This NARS one looks really, really good when I first apply it, but it just comes off my face. But I wanna love it. I think I need to use this one some more, so I'm gonna put it on my desk. Luminous Silk, freaking beautiful. I have had this for like 4-5 years now, so I should probably get rid of it and just buy a new one, because it's very, very old. Okay, fine. This Smashbox one, Katie loves this one. I need to try it some more. I have mixed feelings about it, so I'm putting it on my desk. Maybelline Superstay is such a good full coverage foundation for drugstore. Bobbi Brown Skin Longwear Weightless. I didn't love this one, so I'm gonna get rid of it. I have some shades of the Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I like to prime my eyes with this concealer a lot, so I will hang on to all of these. I can really use kind of like any of these colors. I have a Kevin Kwan Sensual Skin Enhancer. This guy's really, really old too, and it's way too pink for me, so I will get rid of that. MAC Studio Fix, great. Keeping. This CoverGirl matte one I don't like. I prefer the Maybelline one over it, so I will get rid of this one. This Jouer one I've only worn like a few times, but it is so full coverage, I'm keeping it. Kat Von D, hate this foundation. Getting rid of it. NARS Tinted Moisturizer. It doesn't close. Broken. And then the Marc Jacobs Shameless Foundation. It's not my color, so I'm gonna get rid of it. Okay, that's great. Drawer's empty. Oh! There's one hiding. Hi, Huda. How are you? This one is way too dark for me, way too full coverage, and it smells like your grandmother, so I'm getting rid of it. I asked on Instagram what you guys think of IKEA drawers, and so many people were telling me that the drawers don't pull out all the way. Well, neither does this one. So, I don't care. Ooh, but I did buy new organizers. Can I put foundations in it? Like I said, I went to Home Goods, and I love the organizer section. So I bought this. $15, man. Okay, so we got like this guy, that's nice for that. Ooh, yes, some like little ones here that'd be good for like eyeliners. This is meant for your kitchen stuff, but this is makeup. Would this fit in here? God damn it. Would it fit in Alex drawers? Fuck, that sucks. Okay, we'll come back to that. I have a lot of concealers. I do want to make like a separate concealer drawer once I get my Alex drawers, but I will just throw them back there for now. Okay, next foundation drawer. This one has like my pale foundations and some primers and powder, so there's kind of a mix in here. Love this one. Love this one. Wonder Glow. Still trying to figure out how to use this, but I'm keeping it. More Born This Way concealer. Have this one in my lighter shade as well. Still love it. Naked Skin, it's pretty good. I'm gonna hang on to it. Makeup Forever Y205. I don't love this foundation, but I think I only kept this because it's the lightest shade like I have, so it's a really good mixer if I need to lighten the foundation, so I will hang on to that. Gonna get rid of this one. Fenty Lavender Powder. Still trying to figure out how to use this, so I'm probably gonna put it on my desk. This is a really old concealer. I'm gonna get rid of it. And I'm probably not gonna use this Makeup Forever one. Getting rid of that. I love Hello Happy. This powder is like 10 years old, and I have the Laura Mercier pressed powder, so I'll get rid of this one. More of those Smashbox concealers. I don't know what shade I am, so I'm gonna keep them. Hourglass Veil Powder, it is beautiful, hanging on to that. Urban Decay All Nighter Concealer. I do like this one, but I think I have ones that I really like more, so I'm gonna get rid of it. Oh my gosh, one more friggin' Smashbox concealer. Swear to God. This Pretty Vulgar powder. I think I got it in like a Ipsy bag or something. I'm never gonna use this. I'm getting rid of it. Maybelline Fit Me powder. This stuff is good. I need to use this again, so I'm gonna put it on my desk. Okay, then we have some extra primers in here. Ooh, I forgot about this one. Professional Pearl. That's a good one. Bobbi Brown Primer Plus Mattifier. I'm gonna keep it. CoverFX Blurring Primer. Do I like this one? I'm gonna get rid of this one. These are really old as well, so I'm gonna get rid of these two. Smashbox Primerizer is the shit, so I'm keeping it. This one's really old as well, and you can see it's like separated in there, so that's garbage. Hourglass Veil is really, really pretty, so I'm gonna keep that. And I do kind of like this Prime and Peachy one as well, so I'm gonna keep that as well. Okie dokie. This highlighter drawer does not need to be this full. I don't use this many highlighters, honestly. Okay, Pretty Vulgar. I think this came in an Ipsy bag. I don't like it. MAC Soft and Gentle. Oh, it's such a good one. Keep it. This Essence Nude. I'm keeping. This Melt one. Keeping. Becca Gradient looking one. How fun is that? Keeping. Again, we have to keep Fenty. More Fenty. Ooh, I'm actually gonna put this one on my desk because I need to get more use out of this. I think this is the Ofra and Nikki Tutorials one. Cute. This is the Dose of Colors Desi Katie Fuego. This one's too dark for me no matter what I do. Like, it's just, it's so gold and it's not the type of highlighter I like to wear. I definitely have to give this one to a friend because I'm not gonna wear this. It's too dark. This Artist Couture pressed one in Hot Damn. I haven't gotten much use out of this either. This one's kind of dark as well. I think I am gonna hang on to it just cause I can make it work. I'm gonna try it. More Fenty. You're never gonna see me wear these colors, but it's Fenty. This little Lancôme, little doohickey. Oh, it's really soft. It's kind of pink. I'm gonna get rid of it. The Naked Cherry Highlight Blush Palette. This highlighter is freaking stunning, so I'm gonna save that. This Mally palette, I'm gonna get rid of. Dandelion Twinkle, you guys know I love this as an all-over face glow, so of course saving that. This Loose Wet n Wild one, it's called I'm Lit, is beautiful. We have the Balm little palette here. I'm actually gonna get rid of this one because I feel like there's better highlighters out there. This Ofra Glow Up palette. This one's super pretty, but I think I'm gonna get rid of this Nikki Tutorials one then, just because like there's the same colors and I'd rather have a big palette. Oh my god, Jaclyn Hill and Becca. This thing is disgusting. This thing is so gross. I freaking love this palette. I haven't used it in probably like 2 years, but I can't get rid of this. It's beautiful. I have the little Kaja Mochi Glow highlighters. This one's too dark, not gonna use it. This one's a little too pink, so I'm not gonna use that, but I will keep the lightest one. Now we have some kind of liquid highlighters here. Oh, I don't know, guys. I have a few Cover Effects. Oh, these are so nice, though. I'm keeping these. These are beautiful. I also have some mini Cover Effects. I'm gonna keep these too because they're beautiful. This Morphe crayon thing, not gonna use. And I probably won't use this Deck of Scarlet one. It's a little too rose gold for me. I will keep Anastasia Liquid Glow. This stuff is really, really pretty. Now we have some smaller things back here. We have some Artist Couture, Illuminati, freaking beautiful. Laura Geller Gilded Honey. Do you guys remember when this was like a big highlighter as well? Holy shit, keeping that. I have a little mini of Becca Opal. I do really like this one. Oh my gosh, this Makeup Forever Starlight Powder. Beautiful. I have this Kat Von D one that I never used, getting rid of it. This Catrice kind of jelly highlighter, getting rid of it. Now I have some more Artist Couture. I'm gonna get rid of this Supernova one because I really don't like colored highlighters, but I will keep the other two, which are Yas and Coco Bling. This is what I'm at. That drawer is much, much better. This last drawer up here is all cream face products and it's pretty empty because I'm kind of new to getting some cream face stuff. So I'm gonna keep this one as it is. This drawer up here is tools, so that's fine as it is. I did just go through my glitter drawer maybe a few weeks ago, so I did clear out a lot of stuff, but I kind of want to try maybe using these organizers in there. Let me just play around with this. That's better. Now I have my favorite like Urban Decay ones up front here. These are some Wet n Wild. I got some Stila back there and then I put all these little Fenty ones back there. I think this might be the most organized drawer out of all of them. Pretty good. I did go through my eyeliner drawer a few weeks ago as well, so I'm gonna keep it as it is. I just got like neutral colors here, more colorful liners here, and then like my eyeshadow base primers and more kind of stick stuff there. My blush drawer is good as well. I did clear out some of it. Not too worried about it. I guess I did my lip drawer too a while ago. When I get my Alex drawers, I want to make one drawer for all nude glosses because those are just like my favorite thing ever. I have liquid lipsticks here and kind of a mixture back there, and then some tube lipsticks kind of hanging on the side. This drawer I kind of hate just because it's colored lipsticks like purples and reds and stuff that I never ever ever wear, but I keep them just in case, like one day I'll need it, you know?
This drawer is pretty good as well. It's all my sprays. And then on my desk, I just have some products that I want to try out that I pulled aside. So like that Smashbox, NARS, Fenty, ColourPop. Oh, these two together. Yes. Now I have some like PR and just new stuff to go through. Ugh. I'm going to do this off camera though. I don't want to deal with this. Once I get my new desk, I probably won't have this thing on top of it. And it's going to look so nice and pretty. It's from IKEA. Once I get it, I'll tell you guys. It's going to have like two drawers right here. So I can put a lot of my stuff up here that I use every day in these drawers. So it's going to clear up a lot of room and I'm super excited. And then for this kind of stuff, I want to get one of those like three-tiered carts to just kind of chill next to me. So it just kind of looks prettier than this than having it thrown in a bin and just kept in boxes, you know, kind of more organized. I think that'll be really cute. And this is all the makeup that I'm getting rid of today. I feel like that's pretty good for a quick little declutter. I love just kind of clearing up my area and clearing out some stuff that I know I'm not going to use anymore. I will, of course, let my friends and family go through this. I will be donating what is donatable. And some of it is just kind of straight up garbage, like this half-ass empty spray. Gross. That was definitely a different kind of video for me to film, but I thought it'd be fun just to kind of take you guys along the way and kind of see my new stuff. There's my plant hanging there. It's a little drapey plant. I don't know my plants. It's a silver pathos. I got new knobs on my dresser. I've had that dresser since I was like a baby. It had like basic little white knobs in it, so I thought some like kind of glittery knobs would be cute. And I got this cool kind of textured little painting up there from Home Goods. I thought it was super cute and just kind of like neutral and fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I will be back soon with some tutorials, I promise. Just give me some time. I love you all so much, and don't forget to like and subscribe. My key Mao came. Do you want to see my cat? You were roaming, so you had to come see me? But you can't sit on my lap right now. You can't be a lap kitty right now. What do you need? She says, what are you doing, mother? What is this? What is this thing? That is Portia. She is my new child. Yeah. Okay. Bye.